Welcome back. I'm pretty excited in this video because we've got vCF5 that we can upgrade to. If you recall, in a previous video, I did want to take you through the entire process. So here we're going to upgrade from 4.5 to 5. That includes NSX 4.1 and all the other good benefits. Now we will also go through the BOM and check it out. To do so, we click on release versions on the left-hand side, click on version 5, and down the bottom right, you can see BOM or bill of materials. We've got Lifecycle Manager 8.10, we've got SDDC Manager 5, NSX 4.1.0.2, which is great because 4.1 had a bit of a bug in it that caused a bit of data loss, which has been removed from Customer Connect. Then we've got VCSA 8.0.1 and ESXi 8.0.1. So we're getting the new version of vCenter and ESX as well. First things first, jump into workload domains. Let's go to bundle management. I will show you that I've pre-downloaded a bunch of the files just to make things a bit faster and quicker. So we've got the updates for version 5 from the top down. And then if anything else is required subsequently, it will tell us as part of the upgrade. Let's go back to workload domains, click on the workload domain, patches. We have to do the pre-check. Let that complete, it takes a couple of minutes. You can also view the status and follow along as it's going. We can see that it says the pre-check has failed. Let's have a look and see why. Under NSX, it says NSX audit status has failed. It's unable to communicate with host one. It's basically saying status is unknown. We look in NSX, we can sort of see what it's talking about. See there, the node status is unknown. Now there's a couple of ways you can troubleshoot this. There are log files on the SDDC manager that I typically like to check, which are the operations manager log and the LCM log. I'll open one up for us and I'll start with the LCM log and see what it says. So we can see I've puttied onto the SDDC manager as the VCF account. I'm trying to navigate to var log VMware VCF LCM. That'll take us straight into the directory. And if we have a look, there are a few log files that we can check there. Now if I type in less LCM debug, let's see what it tells us. So I've found the error message in the LCM debug log. To be honest, it's not a whole heap of information to tell us what the problem is, but if we look down, you can see certain things are down. To be honest, it's not really comprehensive as to what we need to do from here, but in this situation, I've had some success with maintenance moding the host in both NSX and vCenter, and then bringing it back, and it typically reinitiates the status or re-triggers the status sync. So in vCenter, let's right-click on the host, enter maintenance mode. Let's let that complete. All right, that is now done. We'll do the same in NSX. So find system, fabric nodes, hosts, and then select the host, go to actions and enter NSX maintenance mode. Oh, didn't like it. It says there's a VIF attached to it, which is kind of odd because there's nothing really on the host at the moment. Okay, so it's not letting me enter maintenance mode. So what I will do is, because there's nothing on the host, I'm just going to go back into vCenter and reboot it, see if that resolves that issue. Now I'm sure there's another way to do this without having to reboot it, but this seems to be the easiest way forward so we can proceed with the video. That is done and we can see it's all up again. Now what we can do is just retry from where it failed. Let's let that finish. There you have it. Everything succeeded this time or passed successfully this time. If you go up to the top, started successfully and it passed. Cool. All right, so let's exit the details. We'll select the version that we want to upgrade to. We're going to 5 and then it will tell you. So this is where I was saying I pre-downloaded everything. If I hadn't, it would ask me to download it. But seeing as I have, I can click on update now to start the process. So there we go. That first part is now going. It's upgrading the SDDC manager first to version 5. We can see there it's going 4.1, 4.5.1 to 5. It's in progress. You can continue to view the update activity as you see fit. It probably takes them somewhere, I think, around 10 to 15 minutes, but we'll come back when it's done. And this is the screen you'll see when it's all completed successfully. So now you just click on finish and it should take you back to the SDDC manager. So we're back in, let's have a look. Cool, version 5. So we need to go back into workload domains, click on the workload domain, go to updates, and then we'll go through the sequence and do the next update. We don't need to do a pre-check because we've already done one. You can see here, planned upgrade, we've got available updates. Next, it's going to be doing the config drift bundle. So now we'll click on update now and kick that off and away it goes. We can see in the tasks there, it's currently at 0%. It'll eventually kick off and proceed. We can also see some new features. We've got available configuration updates, which we can apply. And then we've also got the ability to see how many bundles have been applied to get to the target version. So we can click on view bundles and see what else is required. The config drift bundle is what we're doing now. We've still got NSX. Close the task pane here. Got vCenter and ESXi. Config drift bundle has successfully completed. Let's move back into the update section and see what else we've got left to do. Let's have a look at this. We can apply this as it says here. The following configuration updates available to be applied currently. More may become available if additional resources and bundles are applied. they can be applied at any time between upgrade bundles or all together at the end. So we can do this now or we can do this at the end. I'm just going to click on apply all now. If you don't see anything happening in the UI, remember you've got the tasks pane to really figure out what's happening. Config update is good to go. Although now it's saying a bundle failed to download, so I'm going to have to re-download that and we're going to have to come back once it's done because that's next in line. The NSX upgrade bundle for SDDC Manager has finished downloading and is now ready to be updated, or the domain is now ready to be updated to 4102. If I click update now, it will go through a bunch of steps. So just click next, read the prompts. I'm just going to click next, again, next, and hit finish. You can see here the prompt, it says NSX needs to be re-licensed after the upgrade. Let's have a look at that once we get to that stage, but that has now kicked off. Now what that does is, if you have a look in the tasks pane, it's starting the upgrade process, and it's also going to engage upgrade coordinator on NSX managers, and the standard upgrade process for NSX will take place. We'll let it do its thing and we can come back and check all of this out. We can see that NSX is now upgraded. If we go through and have a look at view bundles, NSX is done. If we look in the tasks pane, we'll also be able to see that it's done, but have a look at how many times I actually had to troubleshoot this. And a hot tip here, and keep this in the back of your mind, remember, it is using upgrade coordinator, so you can always go into NSX and have a look to see what's going on, what it's erroring out on, and troubleshoot it through NSX as well. It's not solely dependent on SDDC Manager. So remember, SDDC Manager triggers updates through NSX, and you can still do your standard update troubleshooting through NSX. Next, we want to continue on with updates. What we've got next is vCenter. So we'll click update now, hit confirm. vCenter needs to be relicensed after the upgrade. Mind you, I did check NSX after the fact. It said the same thing, but I couldn't see why it needed to be relicensed because the license keys were still there. I will continue to look at that as this progresses and update if I find anything. Temporary network, essentially what it's going to do is do a migration-based upgrade. So you want to put in a temporary IP address so that way it can do what it needs to do. Effectively, it's just another IP address on the same network. I've put in the details relevant to this network and where vCenter is going to be deployed onto. Now I'll hit next and hit finish, and we'll let that go. All right, so the vCenter upgrade went fine. We can see down the bottom there in the tasks that was successful. But take a note of this, it's saying compatible licenses were not found for vCenter. Now, I did go and check this, and if we go back into my vCenter, we can see that, yes, it is saying vCenter is in eval mode, and that's likely because the key that I had applied to the cluster is not compatible with vCenter 8. So keep that in the back of your mind, you do need to apply a new license key. And the other thing to remember or note is this, the vCenter that was upgraded is still there. So if you need to revert, you can, but it has been renamed and all that sort of stuff. And the new vCenter that we're running is right here, and we can check the version by going into about. So it's version 8. Right, so let's hit update now. And the next one is ESX, which is the last part of the upgrade. So we'll hit update and hit next and go through. You can select any of the options here that you want, but I'm not going to bother as I can just leave it as is. Hit next and finish. We just open up that task. We'll have a look and see what it needs to do. Yep, so it's got to upgrade every host. Well, there's four in my environment, and you can see it's already running on host one. You can monitor this through vCenter, just have a look when in maintenance mode and upgrades, or you can just let it go and as is and troubleshoot if need to when the time arises. So we can see that there's an error. It's failed on the task and it's stopped on host three in region two. If I click on the task, we can see more specifically, it's skipped one. It hasn't actually gotten to that one yet. It's done two successfully and three is where it's failed. We can expand that out and see what it says. Manual remediation may be required. Let's have a look in vCenter. In vCenter, the host is still in maintenance mode. And let's see what the error actually says. Manual intervention, it's failed on host three. Bum install update stage. Let's have a look and see what it thinks the version of host is at the moment. So host one is in error state now currently in the domain for whatever reason, even though it said it was successful. Host three, which is what the actual error was on, says it's still version 703, which we can also confirm in vCenter. Here it's saying it's 801. We can try retrying the upgrade and see what it says. So if we go through, get all the way to the end, we can see that it's now retrying. Where is it up to? It's still doing host three. There's no host three in vCenter is now out of maintenance mode. So maybe it'll work this time. We don't know. Let's wait and see and come back once we have some progress. We can see the upgrade process is actually going, much to my surprise, that is. Let's see if it actually completes. If We also go into vCenter, we can see host 4 is being maintenance mode. It is being remediated. Got all good signs. Let's sit tight and see what happens. Looking at the updates page, we can see the same errors about the license keys. That's all fine. Let's ignore that for now. However, it now is saying we're on the latest version, so the upgrade looks to have gone through, even though that I can see failed workflow task, which was the last one that we ran. Oddly enough, if we go into hosts, all of host 1 has remediated itself. Host 4 is now in errored state. If we have a look though, it's still got the right version in vCenter. It's also got the right version and it's up. To me, that's good. That's working. I'll ignore the failed task or workflow for now. There is ways to clean that up. The one thing I did want to mention though is if you leave the host as is in this errored state, in the subsequent upgrade or version, it could cause issues. And I'll show you exactly what I mean because I did face this issue in this video. This is the error message. If you get up to the host stage and one of them is in errored state, and you try to get through the last part of the upgrade, it will come up with scheduling immediate update of bundle failed, upgrade is requested for domain, which is in a failed state. So you do need to remediate that before you can upgrade. Now to do that, I'll walk you through how to do it in this video, but also I will have an accompanying blog article to show you how to do it as well. First thing you're going to need to do is SSH onto SDDC manager. The VCF account is fine, we don't need root. Then we'll grab the host ID in question. In my case, it's host 4. To do so, you go into SDDC Manager, go to Hosts. In the URL, once you're in the host context, you can see it in the URL. Copy that and put it into Notepad. Then we need to run a curl command on the SDDC Manager to invoke an API. This command here, make sure all the quotes and everything is good. And I'll hit Enter on that. That's good. Now, if we go back into SDDC Manager, you should see Hosts. It can take about 10 minutes for it to refresh, so just keep an eye on it. Almost immediately after I refresh the screen, the host has gone back into an active state. Before you run this API command, you 100% want to make sure that the host is not in an errored state for sure. Everything is working and it's functional. If it is actually errored for a reason, then you want to remediate that the right way, which is either decommissioning or repairing the host, whatever it may be. You may also be better placed to contact GSS. And now what you should be able to do is if you do hit that domain error issue, you will at this point, after 10 minutes, be able to go and retry the update and it will work. But hope you like this video. That's pretty much everything that I wanted to show you for the upgrade process and hit some gotchas along the way and showed you how to remediate it. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.